The Enneagram is a personality typing system made up of 9 unique personality types, each focusing on how we deal with trauma and stress. And while it's mostly simple, there are some things about the Enneagram that may need more explaining before you continue on with this video, so I recommend watching my video where I give a basic understanding of how it all works. Because today, I'm going to be taking an in-depth look at how characters in film portray personality type 2, the Helper. Twos are often recognized for their generosity, always caring for others with their nurturing warmth and loving nature, prioritizing others' needs and desires over their own. However, it is because of their selfless and hospitable reputation that, on the surface, type 2s may not seem like the most complex or mysterious type on the Enneagram, but this is exactly what they would have you believe. All three personalities within the heart center share a sadness for abandoning themselves to create an image that would give them the love and approval they feel they didn't receive in their childhoods, which is why the heart center is sometimes called the image center. While threes are out of touch with their sadness as they create an image of success and achievement, and fours overexpress their sadness as they present themselves as unique and special, twos are in conflict with their sadness as they strive for a likable and pleasing image.
Merry Christmas, girl!
They have a great fear of rejection, and believe that to be rejected by someone means that they are somehow unlovable as they are, and cannot meet their own needs, otherwise it would be selfish. Thus, they feel that they must put on a pleasant face and be helpful and charming to others as a way of seducing them into liking them and meeting their disowned needs in return, giving them the assurance that they are, in fact, lovable. Because of this, twos are often empathetic, sincere, and emotionally attuned to others, willing to help even when it's inconvenient or difficult to do so, all in the name of love.
Please, there's gotta be somebody to find my image.
Mrs. Otterton.
I will find him.
However, in accordance with the theory of the Enneagram, their greatest strength is also their greatest weakness. They can overdo their focus on relationships and winning others' affections and approval to the point where they have nothing left for themselves. This is only made worse when their generosity and dedication to others goes unnoticed and isn't reciprocated. Twos can have an unconscious habit of not only manipulating others, but manipulating themselves into believing that they are stronger than they actually are, or more integral to others than they might be, which is when they engage in their emotional passion. Pride.
It'll be a book in my honor for saving your life and nursing you back to health.
Oh, Paul, you're gonna make me the envy of the whole world.
Each type on the Enneagram has an emotional passion, a vice that they engage in that serves as an unconscious driver that's motivated by a sense of lack, which creates a basic dilemma or trap around the personality. And in the case of type 2, it's pride. Not pride in the healthy sense of accomplishment, but an unconscious pride that twos inflate themselves with in order to take on the needs and desires of others so as to win their love and approval, even when they can't, which can lead to them feeling exhausted and stretched too thin.
I do this time after time after time. I do all this shit for other people, and then I wake up and I'm empty. I have nothing.
This constant struggle of helping others as a way of having them meet their needs in return can cause them to move towards either 8 or 4. The move to 8 can symbolize a frustration for not having their helpfulness or love reciprocated, as well as an ownership over their power and authority, allowing for twos to use their anger as a way to handle conflict and confrontation and be more direct with what they want. The move to 4, on the other hand, represents a return to feeling their emotions authentically, allowing them to more openly accept and express their own disowned needs and address them as they would the needs of someone they love. The way in which the two's pride manifests itself differs among the three instinctual subtypes, but they all involve a need to seduce others into meeting their disowned needs. Self-preservation twos seduce others through presenting themselves as sweet and innocent.
We want our love to be eternal.
Cool.
Social twos seduce through having influence and being ambitious.
Never again will the land of my people fall into enemy hands!
And one-to-one twos seduce through charm and romance.
I've been burnt by you before.
The number of films centered around type 2 characters is significantly less than movies centered around other Enneagram personalities, making twos the Enneagram type with the least amount of representation in film. If I were to make an average number of the amount of films I would classify for other types, it would be around 35 movies per type for the purposes of the series. The amount of type 2 movies I have is 23, and one of them is a joke answer.
Are you okay, Danny?
I'm okay.
Are you okay?
Not only that, but most of the time they're only supporting characters to the protagonist. Hell, not even Mr. Rogers is the main character of his own movie. Thankfully, however, the few Type 2 movies I have here to talk about will be more than enough for this video. So without further ado, let's dive in, starting with Unhealthy Twos.
Mom? What are you doing here in the middle of the night?
You're just in time for supper, dear.
Unhealthy twos repress a lot of anger and pain within themselves and firmly believe that they cannot allow themselves to be rejected. For twos, being rejected means being unlovable, and nothing is worse than being unloved. But for the unhealthy two, love isn't love at all. It's a transaction of meeting needs, and when the object of their affection doesn't hold up their end of the deal, which they most likely didn't agree to in the first place, unhealthy twos become dangerous. Take, for example, the unhealthiest type 2 character of all, Annie Wilkes from Misery.
We're put on this earth to help people, Paul. Like I'm trying to help you. Please, help me help you.
When her favorite author, Paul Sheldon, gets into a car accident, ex-nurse Annie Wilkes rescues him and tries to rehabilitate him in her home. Now at first, she's like most twos. Annie comes across as a sweet and caring person. However, it's important to keep in mind that twos are a part of the image center, and in the case of unhealthy twos, their sweet and caring persona is merely just a front to the anger, pain, and delusional sense of entitlement they have stored up beneath their nurturing facade. They use their generosity as a means to get the needs and desires they disown themselves met by someone else. In short, they give to get, and when they don't get what they feel entitled to, the two's stress move to 8 becomes very apparent.
What's the matter? I'll tell you what's the matter. I go out of my way for you. I do everything to try and make you happy. I feed you, I clean you, I dress you, and what thanks do I get?
Annie Wilkes believes that she is entitled to Paul's love and life since she's his number one fan. Because type 2's core fear is being unloved, unhealthy 2's are driven to extreme lengths to ensure that their fear never becomes a reality, which is why unhealthy 2's exhibit a desperate possessiveness over the ones they want to be loved by. The irony is that the extreme lengths they go through is the very thing that manifests their fear into being, and in the case of Annie Wilkes, those extreme lengths involve crippling Paul so that he may never leave her.
It's for the best.
Annie, please!
Almost done.
And in doing so, ensures that he never loves her.
Hi, pumpkin!
No matter how destructive she is, Annie is able to interpret whatever she does as good through self-manipulation.
Now don't be afraid. I love you.
But in the end, like most unhealthy characters, Annie Wilkes dooms herself into living her core fear due to the desperate and extreme actions she took to prevent it. A similar but more family-friendly social 2 villain would be Lotso Huggenbear from Toy Story 3.
Welcome to Sunnyside, folks.
Again, at first he appears very friendly, warm, and caring.
What a nice bear.
And he smells like strawberries.
But it's all a front to cover the anger and pain he still holds from when his owner forgot him. Unhealthy 2s that make the move to 8 will exhibit the controlling behaviors of unhealthy 8s as they put others in positions where the unhealthy 2s are needed by them. In this way, Lotso builds a hierarchy in the daycare center that ensures that he will always be needed by others and in turn, fuel his pride. However, no amount of being needed or pride can heal his pain from being rejected, and like Annie, dooms himself to his very fear.
No, wait a minute, baby, wait!
After analyzing more unhealthy characters, I started to notice a commonality between them all, regardless of their Enneagram type. The fear of unhealthy characters is so great that they will cross any moral lines needed to ensure their fear never becomes a reality. However, they aren't courageously facing their fear, but rather desperately sacrificing their humanity in hopes that it never comes true. For unhealthy type 1 characters, it was the fear of disorder and imperfections, and for unhealthy type 2s, it's the fear of being rejected and unlovable. What separates the average type 2 characters from the unhealthy type 2 characters, however, is that they learn to actually face their fear of rejection through lowering their pride and embracing humility. Like Boromir from The Lord of the Rings, a character who really showcases the pride and internal conflict of emotions often associated with social 2s, as he struggles between the duty of protecting Frodo and the unbelievable pressure put on him by his father to take the ring to save their people.
Long has my father, the steward of Gondor, kept the forces of Mordor at bay. By the blood of our people are your lands kept safe.
For social twos, pride manifests in the form of being an influential person and having their ability recognized by those they deem important, just like how Boromir takes great pride in serving the people of Gondor and gaining his father's approval, and for better or worse, always keeps their interest in mind and in his heart.
He looks to me to make things right, and I would do it. I would see the glory of Gondor restored.
When Boromir is first introduced, he's really prideful and looks down on Aragorn without even knowing he's the rightful heir to the throne.
You owe him your allegiance. Gondor has no king.
But as prideful as he is, he's still highly empathetic of others and often focuses his attention on their emotional needs when others fail to do so.
Give them a moment, for pity's sake!
He wishes to give hope to both the Fellowship and his people, even when he doesn't have any himself.
It's long since we had any hope.
Boromir believes he must be more than what he already is, thus explaining why he inflates himself with pride. And it's through this weight he carries that the ring starts to tempt him and ultimately lead him to desperation.
I ask only for the strength to defend my feet.
And the ring takes him, but only for a moment before he snaps out of it and recognizes what he's done.
Frodo.
In the end, he sacrifices himself for the Fellowship, but feels as though he has failed everyone, that ultimately, he wasn't enough as he was.
It is over. The world of men will fall.
But Aragorn assures him that he kept his honor, that he was enough, and that as king, Aragorn will keep the people of Gondor safe.
I swear to you, I will not let the White City fall.
And with that, Boromir dies with humility and hope for Gondor, knowing that Aragorn would lead them.
My captain.
This is the growth journey for Type 2s, the lowering of self-inflated pride and the embrace of humility, something that Beatrice Chestnut describes in her book The Complete Enneagram as a way of being that is free of the attachment to be better than you really are in order to know that you have value. For a comedic look at this Type 2 character arc, we have Cher from Clueless. When Cher doesn't get things her way, she manipulates people into giving her what she wants by convincing herself that it's to help others, like making two teachers fall in love so that they're happier and give everyone better grades.
The entire student body was utterly grateful for the improvement in their grades.
Cher is a good comedic example of how the two's emotional passion of pride looks like in action.
God, this woman is screaming for a makeover. I'm her only hope.
But things start to change for her once her ex-stepbrother Josh, a nine-wing one, moves in with her and her dad, and a new girl shows up to her school. Now the reason I bring up that Josh is a nine is because it's going to be a good while till I get to do the video on type nines, so I've decided to point them out whenever they show up as supporting characters along the way in the series. And Josh from Clueless is a great example of a nine-wing one.
You don't need me, do you?
No.
I mean, unless you want, Josh, go
to the party.
Okay.
Go.
Okay.
He's laid back and a little socially awkward, but never fails to call Cher out on her BS with the help of his one wing.
I have contributed many hours helping two lonely teachers find romance.
Which I'll bet serves your interests more than theirs.
I am rescuing her from teenage hell. Do you know the wounds of adolescence can take years to heal?
Yeah, and you've never had a mother, so you're acting out on that poor girl like she was your Barbie doll.
But as the movie goes on, the new girl she was helping starts turning against her, causing Cher to re-examine her intentions and move to four.
I decided I needed a complete makeover. Except this time, I make over my soul.
And in the end, she drops her pride and genuinely wants to help others out of humility.
Miss Geist? Cher? I want to help.
Other notable Type 2 characters include PETA and Finnick from the Hunger Games series.
Honey, that thing I did back there for PETA, that was called saving his life.
Anna from Frozen.
Are you serious?
Yes! And it's the latest model.
No, I can't accept this.
You have to. No returns. No exchanges.
Kiki from Kiki's Delivery Service.
Oh, that smells good. Can I help out?
Sure can.
The Corpse Bride, Cedric Diggory, and Mrs. Weasley from Harry Potter.
Where have you been? Harry, how wonderful to see you, dear.
Giselle from Enchanted, and Johnny from The Room.
You're very welcome, Danny. And keep in mind, if you have any problems, talk to me and I will help you.
But while the common theme for average twos was the lowering of pride and the embrace of humility, the common theme for healthy twos is saving and loving others from a truly selfless place. They don't need to have their needs met indirectly or inflate themselves with pride because they know that they themselves are enough as they are, and that it isn't selfish to take care of oneself, but essential to truly be there for others and the ones they love. While unhealthy twos use love and service as a transaction of meeting needs, and average twos struggle between their pride and humility as they strive to earn love, healthy twos have discovered love to already be within themselves, and thus can share it with others selflessly. Healthy Type 2 characters include Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind, Judy Hopps, Mrs. Incredible, Wonder Woman, and most likely a few others that I couldn't think of or find in my research. But the movie that I think best shows the power and beauty of Type 2 would be A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood.
You love people like me.
What are people like you?
Broken people.
I don't think you were broken.
Now, many people almost unanimously agree that Fred Rogers is a 9, but I think that may just be because of his calm and peaceful demeanor. In the documentary Won't You Be My Neighbor, his wife says that he expressed how he truly felt as a child through the Daniel Tiger puppet, a 4-ish character who often expressed feelings of shame. It's often said that the heart types, 2s, 3s, and 4s, feel ashamed for just existing, and unconsciously believe that they have to become something more than what they already are in order to earn the right of existence. 3s believe that they must be successful, 4s believe that they must be unique, and 2s believe that they must be kind and pleasing. But at the core of all 3 is a deep sense of shame for being alive, a shame that Mr. Rogers would express through Daniel Tiger.
I've been wondering if I was a mistake.
It's also been said he felt a lot of anger and would use music and puppets as an outlet, which could represent the conscious move to 8. I can totally understand why he's been typed as a 9 by many, but his relationship with shame and anger, coupled with the fact that 9s are so out of touch with their anger that they can sometimes fail to recognize it at all, leads me to believe that Mr. Rogers was a type 2, and a very healthy 2 at that. The authentic love and genuine kindness that healthy 2s carry within is truly a force that breaks through the worst in people and pulls the best out of them. They selflessly give themselves to help and love in any way they can, free of any self-deception and pride, which perfectly describes Mr. Rogers in the film A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. There's a scene in particular that really reminds me of the 2s I have in my life, where a character asks him if he ever has someone to be there for him, and instead of answering, Mr. Rogers starts comforting the interviewer.
She died when I was young.
I'm sure that if she saw you today, the person you have become, she would be proud of you.
It's similar to the lyric in the song too, by Sleeping At Last. No, I don't want to talk about myself. Tell me where it hurts. Like I mentioned early on in this video, Fred Rogers isn't even the main character of his own movie, but I don't think that's a bad thing. In fact, I think it's rather fitting. What better way to tell a healthy 2 story than through the impact they make on other people's lives? How they care for them, nurture them, and love them into someone better than who they were at the beginning. The movie achieves this very well by having the main character, Lloyd Vogel, be a type 8 journalist who needs to interview Rogers, all while struggling with anger and pain he still holds from his childhood. And it's only fitting that the number 8s grow towards is, in fact, 2. Through empathy, compassion, and great humility, Mr. Rogers is able to truly and authentically love those he cares about into people who know that they are lovable and accepted as they are. The key motivation and goal of type 2s.